YouTuber Logan Paul just boxed Floyd Mayweather. The world champion boxer with 50 professional wins and 0 losses. And he did it with a Charizard chain around his neck. Can we just appreciate how insane that is? The fact that this fight even came together feels like a movie plot. After a mountain of controversies, Logan is soaring to an all-time high in his career. He didn't knock Floyd out, of course, but he still left the ring a winner. It wasn't that long ago that he was under major scrutiny for an incident at a certain forest in Japan. How did a kid from Ohio go from getting famous making vines to filming a dead body and tanking his reputation to fighting Floyd Mayweather and breaking pay-per-view records? His unlikely redemption story is fascinating, but not an accident. We're talking about a guy who can make $1 million in a day from merch sales alone. He might not look like it, but he's a clever entrepreneur who wasn't going to let bad press ruin his entertainment career. Despite his pattern of controversy, how did he avoid fading into obscurity? To know how he did it, we must understand where he came from. Logan didn't become famous from boxing. Instead, he just started making YouTube videos with his brother as a little kid. They weren't doing it to get views, make money, or challenge the next celebrity athlete to a boxing match. They were just having fun. They did this at the perfect time too, because as they grew older, so did the creator economy. All around them, creators on the internet began making full-time incomes, and sometimes millions of dollars, just by posting videos to YouTube, photos to Instagram, or live streaming to Twitch. As young video makers themselves, this must have been plenty of motivation to keep them going. After the short-form video platform Vine had launched, by 2013, the teenage Paul brothers decided to challenge each other to see who could get the most followers. Like the TikTok stars of today, they saw the opportunity that comes with entertaining millions of people. The competition must have been like rocket fuel, because both Logan and Jake grew quickly on Vine. Within the first year, the pair had gone viral. Logan reached 1 million followers, and even dropped out of university to pursue a career as an entertainer. Everything was looking up, and to them, it seemed like nothing could go wrong. And then, Twitter, who owned Vine, announced it would permanently shut down the video platform. It wasn't because it wasn't popular though, they were just having trouble making money with it. Many Vine stars like Logan were left with huge audiences of fans, but one less platform to upload their videos to. Of course, they flocked to the obvious answer. YouTube. To diversify his content and find a new audience, Logan started a daily vlog, and this is where things began to get weird for the hopeful entertainer. He was growing fast, and up to this point his videos were at worst a little annoying, but they were relatively harmless. However, Logan would be the first to admit that uploading every single day had a dark side, and it would take a toll on him.
Being in the spotlight can really, really alter who you are. I was making videos and trying to sell clothing and make money off of the wrong reasons. Somewhere along the line of creating, you know, I went down a fork in the road that was just not me.
In the beginning, these videos were just a showcase of his daily life. Life in LA, conversations with friends, and repetitive tasks like going to the gym or eating lunch. He did his best to make them goofy and entertaining, but soon he decided he needed to do more. At first, his vlogs were about his life, but his appetite for attention pushed him to make his life about the vlogs. They needed to be exciting, have a focused narrative, and up the stakes each time. With each upload, he tried to push boundaries and find the next thing to get people's attention. He filled a school bus with plastic balls, jumped over 2 Lambos, gave his mom $10,000 cash. Basically, the clickbait that delivers stunts that Mr. Beast is known for. Everything was coming together, the perfect storm. A wild personality making a new video every day, and each time he uploaded with the expectation of doing something crazier than before.
You know, when you're doing that, those daily vlog videos, there's always, what's the next big thing, you know, just dangling in front of you. Like, what's gonna draw in more people to the channel? Me filming a dead body? Bah! Not even hesitating.
On New Year's Day, 2018, Logan Paul did the unthinkable. He uploaded a video titled, "We Found a Dead Body in the Japanese Suicide Forest," where him and some friends filmed a corpse up close and showed it to his young audience of millions. The craziest part was that, at the time, it was a rational decision in his mind. He felt he needed to do something drastic to push boundaries, and the people around him didn't help either. Logan had to face what he had done, and the backlash was intense. People were obviously outraged. Fellow YouTubers, major celebrities, and news reporters were criticizing his actions. YouTube themselves even responded by removing him from the Google Preferred program that earned him a higher ad revenue than most creators. It was definitely the biggest mistake he had ever made, and his lowest point yet. Afterwards, he stopped uploading to YouTube, and many thought it was an early end to his career. Except for an apology video, he didn't upload for almost a month. Then, on January 24th, he published a mini documentary with Kevin Hines, a suicide prevention speaker, and with 31 million views to date, it did help raise awareness, though many felt it wasn't enough. Logan revived the vlog, but despite claiming to have turned over a new leaf, he continued to receive negative attention. At this point, he's still constantly under fire, so how did he turn things around?
Jake Paul, Logan Paul, any of the Pauls, I don't care.
The Paul brothers joked about what KSI meant by his statement and initially suggested he should fight their dad. Eventually, though, Logan figured the attention would be good for him and he accepted the offer. Headlines about Logan Paul started to shift from negative to neutral, and you know he was excited.
Exciting stuff. We have a time limit on getting the contract in position to announce
his JJ. Who knows? I could be a professional boxer from now on.
Little did he know that he just stumbled upon a chain of events that would lead him to one of the greatest athletes of all time. And sooner than you may think. You see, this jet was on the way to Las Vegas, where he'd meet with Floyd Mayweather's team all the way back in 2018. There, he began training for the fight against KSI, and one can only assume that's when Logan's manager met with Floyd's, but more on that later. The two YouTube stars would end up fighting each other twice, with a draw for the first match and a loss for Logan in the second. In the end, it was all good fun and they hugged it out in the ring. Logan would go on to say this about boxing.
Boxing did save my life. Really, I was headed down a path that I did not like.
Losing to KSI didn't really matter to him, because he found the next chapter in his career. He wasn't just growing as an athlete, though. His content was going through big changes as well. He stopped posting daily videos to his main channel and started surrounding himself with a new crowd. His co-host of the new Impulsive podcast, Mike Malak, became known as Logan Paul's babysitter. The podcast was an opportunity for everyone to see a more chill, toned-down version of him, and it was made for a whole new target audience. He didn't stop training as a boxer, either. His brother Jake was fighting too, and the competition between them only heightened. Here's where the crazy starts happening. Sometime during the summer of 2020, his manager Jeff Levin, who met with Mayweather's team 2 years prior, came to Logan with a contract and said,
"This is Logan, would you fight Floyd Mayweather?"
And just like that, the biggest fight of his life was actually going to happen. Fast forward to today. You've heard the story and seen the clips. Logan was a much bigger opponent with much less experience than Floyd, and neither were able to knock the other out. Although, it felt like there was more hugging than there was punching.
Fans do not want to see them hug it out, that is for sure, with a minute.
Regardless, there were still winners. Logan won, Floyd won, and the pay-per-view company won. Logan probably got the most out of this, though, because he now gets to say he survived a boxing match against one of the best. Amazingly, he defied the odds and really turned things around. Like him or not, he doesn't quit, and he shows no signs of slowing down. This won't be the last you hear about Logan Paul.
"Please, let me fail. Let me lose. If you can take a hit in the face and get back up and learn from that, is a win."
What do you guys think? Will there be a rematch? Let me know in the comments, and subscribe for more creator stories like this one.